Geobite.
Welcome to Geobite. Hi students, in the previous video we have covered the topics exercise number 1.5. In this video let us cover the topics loss of exponents for real numbers and exercise number 1.6. Now let us see loss of exponents for real numbers. See, below we have some questions. Let us answer those questions. See, the first one is 17 power 2 into 17 power 5. It is in the form of, that is the exponential form of a power m into a power n, that is equal to a power m plus n. Right? This is the exponential form, that is a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. When the base are equal, right here we have a. So when the bases are equal, the power must be added. So m and n are the powers, they are added. So here also we have 17 as the base. So when the bases are equal, that is 17, right? The bases are equal. So 17, the powers must be added, 2 plus 5 in the power. So 17 power 2 plus 5 is nothing but 7. So 17 power 7. Now let us see for the second one. We have 5 power 2. Whole power 7, right? It is in the form of a power m whole power n. A power m whole power n. See, a power m whole power n. So, it is in the form of a power m whole power n. It can be written as a power m n. These mn, that is the powers, get multiplied. So a power m whole power n is nothing but a power mn. So here a is nothing but 5 mn, means we need to multiply 2 into 7. So 5 power, right, we have multiplied 2 into 7. So 2 sevens are 14. So 5 power 14. Now let us see third one. We have 23 power 10 by 23 power 7. If you see, it is in the exponential form. A power m by a power n is equal to a power m minus n. Right? When they are in multiplication, the powers get added. When they are in division, the powers get subtracted. Remember this point. So, a power m by a power n is nothing but a power m minus n. So, here a is nothing but 23 power m minus n. That is nothing but 10 minus 7. So, 23 power 10 minus 7 is nothing but 3. So 23 power 3. Now let us see the last one, which is fourth one. We have 7 power 3 into 9 power 3. See, it is in the form of a power m into b power m. Since we have the same powers, that is why we have taken both m and the bases are different. That is why a and b. Now this is written as a into b whole power m. As we have the power same, the bases get multiplied. So a into b whole power m. Here also a is 7, b is 9. So 7 into 9 whole power 3. Now 7 nines are 63 whole power 3. Now let us see exercise number 1.6. In that, the first question, find, there are 3 questions given below. Let us see the first one. We have 64 power 1 by 2, right? Let us write the given question, 64 power 1 by 2. See, if you see clearly, we can write 64 as 8 square whole power 1 by 2. 8 square is nothing but 64. 8 eights are 64. So 8 square is 64 whole power 1 by 2 is written. Now this is in the form of a power m whole power n. Right? A power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. See, a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. Similarly, a power m whole power n. So, a power m into n, that is nothing but 8 power 2 into 1 by 2. 2 into 1 by 2. 2, 2 gets cancelled. So, 8 power 1 is left. 8 power 1 is nothing but 8. Right? Now, let us see second one. We have 32 power 1 by 5. See, let us write the given question. 32 power 1 by 5. See, 32 can be written as 2 power 5 whole power 1 by 5. 32 is written as 2 power 5. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? 2 2's are 4. 4 2's are 8. 8 2's are 16. 16 2's are 32. So it is nothing but 2 power 5 since we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 2's. I have written 2 power 5. Now, this is also in the form of a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. So here a power m into n means 2 power 5 into 1 by 5. Now 5 and 5 gets cancelled. 2 is left over. So 2. 2 power 1 is 2. Now let us see third one. We have 125 whole power 1 by 3. See, let us write the given question. 125 whole power 1 by 3. Now 125 can be written as 5 cube, that is 5 power 3 power 1 by 3. 5 power 3 whole power 1 by 3. See, 5 into 5 into 5. 5 5's are 25. 25 5's are 125. So, 5 cube whole power 1 by 3. Same, this is also in the form of a power m whole power n. That is equal to a power m into n. So, here a is 5. And m into n are 3 into 1 by 3. 3 into 1 by 3. So, 3 and 3 gets cancelled. 5 power 1. That is nothing but 5. Now, let us see second question. Find, and below we have 4 questions. Let us solve one by one. The first question is 9 power 3 by 2. Right? Let us write the question. 9 power 3 by 2. Now, if you see, we can write 9 as 3 square. 3 3s are 9. So 3 square whole power 3 by 2. Same, it is in the formula a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. So 3 power 2 into 3 by 2. This 2 and this 2 gets cancelled. We are left with 3 power 3. Right? 2 and 2 got cancelled. We are left with 3 power 3. Now 3 power 3 means 3 into 3 into 3. So 3 3s are 9. 9 3s are 27. Right? The answer is 27. Now let us see second one. We have 32 power 2 by 5. Right? First let us write the given question. 32 power 2 by 5. Now 32 can be written as, yes, 2 power 5 whole power 2 by 5. Right? 2 power 5 whole power 2 by 5. Now this is also in the form of a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. Now 2 power m into n means 5 into 2 by 5. Now this 5 and this 5 gets cancelled. We are left with 2 power 2. Only 2 is left in the power. So 2 power 2. 2 into 2. 2 power 2 is nothing but 2 into 2. 2 2's are 4. Right? 4 is the answer. Now let us see third one. We have 16 power 3 by 4. First let us write the given question. 16 power 3 by 4. Now 16 can be written as 2 power 4 whole power 3 by 4. 16 can be written as 2 power 4. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16. So now this is also in the form of a power m whole power n is equal to a power m into n. Now here a is nothing but 2 and m into n means 4 into 3 by 4. Gets cancelled. We are left with 2 power 3. So 2 power 3. That is nothing but 2 into 2 into 2. 2 2's are 4. 4 2's are 8. So 8 is the answer. Now let us see the last one, which is fourth one. We have 125 whole power minus 1 by 3. First, let us write down the given question. 125 power whole power minus 1 by 3. Now 125 can be written as 5 cube whole power minus 1 by 3. 125 is written as 5 cube. Now this is also in the form a power m whole power n, that is equal to a power m into n. Now, see, a power m into n means 5 power 3 into minus 1 by 3. Right? M into n. 3 into minus 1 by 3. So, 3 and 3 gets cancelled. Now, we are left with 5 power minus 1. 5 power minus 1. See, minus means we need to write 1 by 5. As we have minus 1, we have written minus 1 by, 1 by 5. First, suppose if we have 5 power some minus 4, then we need to write 1 by 5 power 4. So, like that, we have 5 power minus 1. So, we have written 1 by 5. Now, let us see third question. Simplify, and below we have 4 questions. Let us simplify one after the other. The first one is 2 power 2 by 3 into 2 power 1 by 5. First, let us write the given question. 2 power 2 by 3 into 2 power 1 by 5. We know that a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. A power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. Now, here both the bases are equal. When the bases are equal, powers must be added. So, here bases are equal, that is 2. So, we need to add the powers. 2 power 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. So, here the LCM will be, see, 2 power, here LCM will be 15. 5 threes are 15. So, 3 fives are 15. 5 threes are 15. 3 fives are 15. 5 threes are 15. So, LCM is 15. And we get 5 twos are 10 plus 3 ones are 3. Right? So, 5 twos are 10 plus 3 ones are 3. We got 2 power 10 plus 3 is 13 by we have 15. So, 2 power 13 by 15 is the answer. Now, let us see second one. We have 1 by 3 power 3 whole power 7. First, let us write down the given question. 1 by 3 power 3 whole power 7. See, this 1 by 3 power 3 is in the form 1 by a power m, that is equal to a power minus m. 1 by a power m is equal to a power minus m. So, according to this, we can write 3 power minus 3. This a power m is written as a power minus m. So, 3 power 3 is written as 3 power minus 3. Now, whole power, we have 7. Now, see, 3, 7 threes are 21, right? 7 threes are 21, we have minus, so minus 21. This is according to the formula, a power m into n. So, a power m whole power n gives you a power m into n. Since we got the same, we multiplied the both and got minus 21 in the power. So, 3 power minus 21. Now, let us see third one. We have 11 power 1 by 2 by 11 power 1 by 4. First, let us write down the given question. 11 power 1 by 2 by 11 power 1 by 4. Now, it is in the form of a power m by a power n. Right? A power m by a power n is equal to a power m minus n. So, this is the formula. A power m by a power n is equal to a power m minus n. So, here a is nothing but 11 and m minus n. M and n are powers. So, m minus n, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. Now, see, 11 power, here the LCM is 4. So, 2, 2s are 4, 4, 1s are 4. 2, 2s are 4, 4, 1s are 4. Now, 11 power, 1, 2s are 2. minus 1 months are 1 whole by 4, as we got the LCM 4. So 2 minus 1 by 4 is equal to 11 power 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1 by 4, 11 power 1 by 4. Now let us see the last one, that is fourth one. We have 7 power 1 by 2 into 8 power 1 by 2. First let us write down the given question. 7 power 1 by 2 into 8 power 1 by 2. Now this is in the form of a power m into b power m. That is nothing but a into b whole power m. See, a power m into b power m is equal to a into b whole power m. Here the power is same. Since we have the same power, only bases are changed. Here also it is changed. So now we need to multiply the bases. As per this, 7 into 8 whole power m, that is nothing but 1 by 2. 7 8s are 56 whole power 1 by 2. You are welcome to contact us on Telegram to clarify your doubts regarding these topics. Check out the link in the description. Thank you for watching. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe to GeoByte. GeoByte.